This is northbound Dundee at the entrance to eastbound I-90. Vehicle does not stop for the officer. Once on I-90, the officer terminates his attempt to stop the vehicle. The next time officer sees the vehicle is on westbound I-90 on the shoulder.
Four, Cynthia's still in here. Hey, she's reaching, putting something away. I can't tell what she's doing. She's got a bag in her hands. What's that? Yeah?
Put
it down. Cynthia, open up the door now!
Put it down.
Open up the door! Open up the door! Cynthia, you need to open the door. I can't hear you. Still can't hear you. It's really loud out here. What? Cynthia, don't make this any harder on yourself. Just open the door. Cynthia, you almost owned that cigarette? All right. She's trying to pull away.
Whose squad is this? Cynthia, this is the Elgin Police Department. You're under arrest. Turn your car off and step out of the vehicle.
We gotta take her into custody if she comes back out.
Cynthia, this is the Elgin Police Department. You are under arrest. Exit your vehicle with your hands up.
What's the knife look like?
It's a steak knife.
Just a steak knife?
Yeah.
Nothing else? I saw drug paraphernalia.
That's all I saw. A lot of drug paraphernalia. There's some white powdery substance on her left hand that she's probably, I'm assuming, cracked, trying to hide. She's actually stuffing the crack pipe when we walked up to her the second time.
I'm going to be pinning this vehicle in from the front. Who's ever, I think it's Rob, you're right behind, you're going to pin her in out of the rear. Okay?
Stand by it. She just kind of drive like this.
From the view of the front squad car, you will see Miss Clements igniting two items and tossing them into the back seat.
Anyone with me up here?
Exit the vehicle. Yep.
If she gets out, okay, and her hands are empty and she starts coming back,
me and one other jump this. We'll get her to the ground, get her in cuffs.
Open up the door, keep your hands up.
Stay back.
Don't let anyone hurt you.
Yeah. Everybody else stay.
Light smoke, it looks like it's fucking up on the inside. She's rolling the window. Yeah, smoke's coming from the inside. She's rolling down.
She's got the nuts to her neck. She's got the nuts to her neck. Is she stabbing herself?
Putting that to her chest, can't tell if she's making any movement with it.
Okay, why don't you keep on negotiating? Oh, there's a fire going on in the vehicle, guys. There's a fire going on inside the vehicle.
Active fire in the back seat of the vehicle.
All right, we're going to have to, like, extract her here. Stand by.
Hey, Chad, hold back. Hold back. Chad, hold back.
I'm holding back. I'm just getting here. I'll get back over if she jumps out with the knife. Chris, I got my foot on the brake, but... Cynthia, step out of the car for me!
Get out of the car!
Do we need a fire department out there?
Cynthia, step out of the car, Cynthia!
Step out of the car, Cynthia!
Step out of the car! They're screaming, we gotta get her.
We gotta get the window down.
Yep. Stand by.
Hands, team.
Let's go.
No. Get out of the car. Cynthia, step out of the car.
All right, boys, this is gonna be rough here. Okay, look at the taser ready.
Over here. Taser, you one hand, all right?
Chilled. Chilled.
Two hands of tasers.
Paul's got tasers.
Get her out, boys.
You want me to smash the window?
Get the taser set. Get her out.
I got it.
Hold on. You see your hands, Cynthia, your hands.
Hands.
Cynthia, get hands. Out of the car. Hey, put the knife down.
Took off work to go find out what's going on. When I got there, they was pretty much over with her.
Are you her dad, brother?
Huh?
I was
no, her dad and her dad, mom, and my dad were sisters and brothers.
Got it. You're her cousin.
I'm her first cousin. Okay. I mean, she was a good girl, you know? I mean, but there was no reason for what they did to her, you know? Everybody go through their trials and tribulations, but for them to do that, you know, that was unjustifiable. It was really unjustifiable to me, you know, but I'm not the law, so I can't say, you know. But I think they could have took more initiative or more moves instead of what they did.
All right, good morning. My name is Jeff Swoboda. I'm the police chief here in Elgin. I have some very preliminary information of what occurred this morning. And so I really want to stress that it's preliminary information. And second thing I want to stress is that the Illinois State Police is handling the investigation regarding the officer-involved shooting. That is per state law. So I'm not going to get very far in advance of their investigation with my statement. So I will do this preliminary information, open it up for some very basic questions, but I just want to make sure everybody understands the state police who's running with this investigation. So this morning at approximately 12:34 a.m., officers made contact with a suspicious vehicle in the area of Cedar Avenue here in Elgin. During the encounter, the driver, a 34-year-old female, fled from the scene in her vehicle. Officers attempted a traffic stop on the vehicle, in which the vehicle did not stop, and officers then terminated their pursuit. A short time later, her vehicle was located on westbound 90 at 25, near Route 25. It had obvious signs of damage. Elgin officers made contact with the subject and observed that she was armed with a knife. Officers then disengaged immediately and proceeded to negotiate with her for over an hour. During that time, she would periodically move her car up several feet. At one point, officers noticed that a fire had started inside the vehicle. They approached the burning vehicle in an attempt to pull her out. There was an exchange, and that's the part that we're still, that the state police will be investigating what occurred, that then the officer discharged their firearm, striking the female. She was transported to St. Alexis Hospital in Hoffman Estates, where she was pronounced dead. Her name is being withheld pending notification to the family. The Illinois State Police will be investigating the officer-involved portion of this investigation. And again, that is per Illinois state statute. At this time, we're still attempting to make contact with the family, so we are not offering up any information about her. You know, and just on a personal note, I want to express my condolences to the family. Anytime someone loses their life, especially in an incident like this, it's just extremely sad. And so we're working through that within the police department, but I also just want to say, offer our condolences on behalf of the Elgin Police Department to the family. Again, with that, I'll open it up for any questions, but again, I'm not going to go very far because this is not our investigation. So,
the negotiations happened and lasted, you said, about an hour or over an hour?
Over an hour we were negotiating with her.
So what kinds of things were they talking about during that hour? What was causing her to do what she was doing?
We don't know. And when we are negotiating with someone, we're just trying to talk with them and have cases end peacefully. We go on thousands of calls a year, many of which we're negotiating with individuals, and usually we can get them to work with us. But in this case, apparently that obviously didn't happen, and so we're working through exactly what was said, but we're not going to be able to speculate what she was thinking at the time. Well, we got that for you. We can put it out, but in a nutshell, I think where you're getting at is officers use deadly force when they believe they themselves or another person is in imminent danger of death or great bodily harm.
How many officers fired?
Well, that's part of the investigation.
How many officers were on the scene?
Again, I don't have an exact number. Multiple. The officer who discharged the weapon was not alone. Again, we were negotiating with for over an hour. Well, again, this is a very fluid situation. We're out there on patrol in the middle of the night trying to talk with someone. So we've negotiated with, and that's how we do business here in Elgin. We'll negotiate with people for hours. And so, again, I want to also push that it was a fire that had started inside the vehicle that caused us to cut off the negotiations and move in and attempt to pull her out. But, you know, generally speaking, there's a negotiator there. There's someone there also listening and giving them advice, and there are other people watching the person, you know, whether they're in a car or in a house. So it's not a one-person job by any means. However, having said that, there are times where an officer is negotiating with a person just one-on-one, depending on what the call for service is. But this wasn't the case.
Was her demeanor? Was she distraught?
I don't
something?
Know. Whether or not there was damage to the vehicle, we don't know what caused the stop. The car was on the expressway. We found the car on the expressway. We terminated the pursuit. Again, the preliminary information, we terminated the pursuit, went back through the area, saw that the car was stopped with damage, in which we went up and started talking with her, noticed a knife, backed away, started talking with her, and then eventually moved in when a fire started.
Each and every one of you out here is a blessing, and we really, really, truly, truly appreciate it. And we as well, as our little sister, we loved her dearly. We are deeply hurting. We just want to say thank you to everyone out here. And at the end of the day, God has the last say. And my faith is in God. And I just truly want to thank everybody, because you don't have to be out here, but you're here. And from the bottom of the Clements family, the Sneed family, we just want to say thank you. I appreciate it so much.
Justice for Cynthia!